So what's up guys and welcome to a new episode here on Shades of Tech. If you're new to the channel and you don't know me, my name is Fabrizio, but you can call me Fabri. And in today's video we're gonna be talking about my 2021 iPad Pro setup. So last year we made an iPad Pro desk setup as well and you guys really enjoyed it. So in today's episode we're gonna be breaking up the list of my 2021 gear, and as always I'll leave all the links in the description in case I miss something. And also we'll be talking about what means having an iPad Pro in 2021 and if you can use it as a main computer or Mac replacement. But before we start, I want to make clear that yes, some of the gear I'm using in this setup was sent to me for review, but no, I'm not paid or sponsored in any way, and as always all the opinion in this video are my own. So as you can see behind me, there is something different from the usual studio, and the reason is that we are moving studio. So this is a really small and quick sneak peek with some behind of the scene of the new desk setup. So the main brain of the setup is of course an iPad Pro 12.9 inch, but you might be thinking it's an M1 2021, but actually it's not. It's a 2018 iPad Pro, so this is the first version with this new modern design, and I honestly think that the processor inside is strong enough, is powerful enough to make everything I need. So for everything I do, browsing, social network, email, photo editing, it's really smooth and fast, and with the ProMotion display 120Hz you can still make something and make it look really really fast. And I'm rocking iPadOS 15 beta, so I'm testing and it seems to run and hold up pretty well. But you might be thinking, what is the case that I'm using with the iPad Pro? Well, it's the floating case from Moff, and I really love it because the look and the design is like my dream iMac should be, not the M1 Mac that Apple made. You can put of course in different position, this is the floating one. There are also the portrait and landscape mode. It's really easy to fit, to put on, and it's really resistant, so if the iPad Pro drops it will cover and protect it. It's a really suggested case, and there is both in 12.9 and 11 inch version. So my daily monitor that I use every time with my iPad Pro and my Mac Mini is the BenQ PD2725U. It's 4K, it's HDR400, of course 60Hz, 16.9, but it's a design monitor, so the colors are really really vibrant, the HDR is really really full, and the colors are really good. So I upgraded from my 4K LG monitor, which just HDR10, to this one, and I'm really happy, especially for video editing. It's really really cool, and with this iPad I make a lot of photo editing for my Instagram. It covers 100% of sRGB or Rec. 709 color space and 95% of P3 color space. It has Thunderbolt 3, so if you have the M1 iPad Pro it will work really well as well, and you can daisy chain, so it's perfect for your Mac or Apple devices. You can charge your iPad or MacBook, and I'm feeling really well because I still love the design. The problem with my LG, apart from the colors that weren't very accurate, was the design. It was all plastic, and with this one you have a really professional stand that you can turn around, so if you are making some client work it works really well, and it make you look really really professional. And beside that, on top you can see the BenQ screen bar. At first I was a little bit skeptical on these bars, but the more I use, especially in this new studio which is really dark, basically it's a lamp, you can adjust the power, so the intensity of the light, and also the color temperature, so according to if you are video editing or watching a movie you can adjust it. It has automatic function that are just up to 500 lux, and also it's all metal, so the design is really really cool, especially at late at night. It's really a saving because it doesn't create screen glare. In fact, the light is asymmetrical, so it doesn't go against the screen, so no screen glare, but it will highlight all the part below the monitor, so it will be simpler for your eyes to work, not in the dark. As you know from my channel, I love LED, RGB, RGBIC, and for this setup I choose not to use an LED strip because this has a more on-the-go setup, so it will vary on time, so I wanted something that was easy to put and remove, and so I choose the Flow Pro from Goovy, and I didn't have the time to review them, but I've used since they were in pre-release phase, and with the latest update they improved so much because now you can basically divide each bar in 8 sections and you can change the color for each one of them. If you want to, you can also mount a camera that will match the ambilight colors to what's on the screen, but being a Mac setup, an iPad Pro setup, there aren't a lot of changing in the colors. There was also the BenQ lamp on the top, so I decided to leave it cleaner in this way. Now let's talk about the desk. It's nothing special, it's from IKEA, and basically the tabletop costs less than the legs. And basically the one thing that I wanted for this new YouTube studio was to have everything on wheel, so I have mounted wheels under every furniture and table that I have, and even under the couch, so that I can move as I want. And to make this setup even smarter, I use the GoSun power link adapter, and each power plug can be controlled via smartphone with the GoSun app and with the Alexa or Google Home Assistant. So it's really neat. You can for example tell Alexa to turn off all the light when you go away from your studio, or you can create timers or a time of the day where you are out of the office, so all the lights will be turned off. So it's really cool. And so GoSun makes also different power plugs and the LED strip that are controlled all with Alexa. And basically I'm testing Alexa and it's so much better than Google Home. I'm probably start a word in the comment, but I think really that Alexa is better right now. So one downside of the iPad Pro mouth case in floating mode is that it will wobble a lot if you move the table or if you touch screen. So touch screen is not a good idea with this one. And as always, I prefer to use mouse and keyboard for the iPad Pro when I'm not on the go, when I'm in the office. So I went with my usual trio that you probably know. So the Satechi X3 Smart Keyboard with Keylight. I have the Apple Magic Keyboard, but Apple nailed the design, but is missing the backlight feature that I think is very important when editing at night. You can set the brightness of the keys. And so I love it for this reason, and because you can pair with up to 3 different devices. And the same thing with the MX Master Gen 3 that I love for video editing on the Mac. But with the iPad Pro it's not very optimized. For example, the infinite scroll is not optimized. What I think it's really optimized is the Apple Magic Trackpad for the iPad Pro with all the gesture, and so I use it as well. And of course when I'm photo editing, a must is the Apple Pencil Gen 2, and it's so convenient, I love it every time, and it saves a lot of time. For the audio I usually use the Apple AirPods Pro, but for this setup I'm rocking the Transmart Apollo Q10. And the reason is simple, because with just 50 bucks they deliver pretty decent and good ANC, and they are over ear. So the only downside is that you can't plug them to the iPad Pro to reduce the lag if you are video editing. So all the gear I use in this setup is out of the way, but now let's talk about the real topic of this video. So using only an iPad Pro in 2021, well, in 2019 when I bought this 2018 iPad Pro, I decided to sell my MacBook Pro. I only use my Mac Mini for video editing, as I was saying, because you can video editing, there are some cool apps like LumaFusion. I find it really complex and I prefer to use Final Cut Pro. So the main topic of this video is that Apple is basically nerfing the iPad Pro lineup in favor of sale of Macs, especially the portable one, MacBook Pro and MacBook Air. And for this reason, in my opinion, the iPad Pro with M1 will have not any problem of running macOS or an hybrid system, but Apple is deliberately not making that. And in this way, the result is what you have seen for all this video, for example, which is really simple and stupid, but black bars. Why the iPad can only mirror the display with an external display and not extend the display with different desktop. I think it will be able to do that flawlessly without any problem with RAM. For me, the video editing takes more time. It's not that iPad Pro can do that, because exporting times with LumaFusion are extremely fast and comparable to the M1 Mac, even if this iPad rocks a previous gen processor. But the problem is software optimization, and if Apple doesn't want to make that and to leave these two different categories, it's up to them. There is some opening from Apple with universal control. Basically, with macOS Monterey and iPadOS 15, you will be able to control both your iPad and Mac with only one set of keyboard. And I think it's really, really cool, and I'm really looking forward to do that, because in this way you won't have to switch, but just extend your display. And I think that this is more important than you think, because this is an opening. So I really think that in WWDC next year, so 2022, we will see an hybrid version of macOS that will run on different platform, all with M1 Max. But the bad news is that probably those 2018 and 2019 iPad Pro won't support it, because they don't run M1 Mac. This wraps up for today. Let me know what you think about your iPad Pro, if you own one, if you use one, what are your impressions of this setup. And if you like this video, please leave a big like and subscribe. And if you didn't like, a dislike works as well. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Ciao!